friends, my name is Dolores and I am a fine artist and instructor residing in beautiful Kenya. I'll be giving lessons on how to paint simple objects like a still life and more challenging things like a portrait in charcoal, in oils, landscape painting and many more. Karibu to my channel. I would like to teach you how to paint in oils if you've never done that before. And I will show you the different materials that you can use. We're going to start with the painting surfaces. These are all the things that you can get in the market here. You can get these canvas pads or canvas papers. They are papers, but they are thick and they have the texture of canvas. As you know, this is the stretch canvas that you get in the stores. You can also buy a roll of canvas or many meters as you want and take them to a carpenter to get it framed. These are other art stores. They sell these in packs. They are very cheap. So they are canvas panels. And the ones that I prefer for my everyday painting of small things and when I go to paint outside or plein air is the MDF. The MDF gives me many alternatives. It's light, it's archival quality, and it's very cheap. I can buy a big plank of MDF and get it cut by a carpenter in different sizes. I can carry them very easily. The only thing, they don't have texture. They're like glassy. And the difference with the canvas is that they have a texture, as you can see. But I need to prepare this. I need to prime it because if I put the oils directly, they will sink inside. So what I'm going to show you now is how to prepare. I bought some white acrylic. I have this plate. And I'll just use the sponge. I am making sure that the place that I'm in is ventilated. And I apply a first layer. Try to have it even. It doesn't need to be perfect. Just cover with one layer of acrylic, white acrylic. I let it dry for maybe half an hour, and I'll show you what we'll do next. When that is dry, I have to even it with sandpaper. I choose a fine grain sandpaper. To make sure that this is even. Now I have one layer of white. I'll go with another layer of white. Again, same process. So imagine that this is my first one. It's going for the second layer of white. Evenly, same thing. When it dries, in 20 minutes, half an hour, sand it again, and my third layer will be gray. This is the way I do it. I've learned many years ago, and it has worked for me. In the future, you may find a color that you may like better, but let me show you a little bit of why I prefer the gray tone. I tone in gray everything I do, as you can see in the portrait thing, because it makes the color pop up immediately. And if you see this painting of this lion cub, you can tell everybody that I asked to say, what color is the eye of the lion cub? And they say, it has brown, it has blue, it has this and that. And I say, except for that little point of black and a little turquoise, it doesn't have any color. It's just, I just left the gray on the back. So the gray works for me. Maybe it will work for you. Let's go to the next video. Now we're going to be preparing our palette. The traditional palette that you use is the wooden one. Try to get a lightweight one and not a very small one because you're going to need a lot of place to put your oils and mix your colors and everything else. But as with the MDF, we have to prime it, because if not, the oils will just sink in. So you can do a first layer in the morning, an even layer, cover the whole palette with the linseed oil. And the linseed oil doesn't need to be the expensive brand. You can just go to the hardware and get linseed oil that is not refined, and that will work just the same. So you give a layer in the morning, you cover it with another layer by noontime, and by night you give another layer. At least 3 layers. That will work. You can put more if you like. So this is a traditional wooden palette. Now we go to a different wooden palette that works very well too. See, I bought this frame photograph for photographs. I just took the hooks. Now I take the glass. Glass is very good for the oil paintings. I will just take this. And now I'm gonna prepare a paper with a gray tone. So I get a thick paper, any paper that is thick. I measure it. Okay, and then I cut it. Oh, before that, I have to tone it. So remember that I already have my mixture. And I'm gonna cover the whole thing. With the same color that I used to tone my canvas. So when I put my color there, over the glass, I'll have the exact feeling of the color that I already put in the canvas. Now that my paper has dried, I cut it in the same shape. Put it over the foam in this place. And I have a very nice size glass palette to work on with my paintings, to prepare my colors and to use for mixing colors. With the papers that are left, I cut them to give them these shapes. That those are the shapes that you get on your canvases, the square one and the rectangular one. And I'm gonna show you when I invite you to follow me when I paint a fruit, how we use these viewfinders. That's the name for that. This is a viewfinder. So now we have the wooden palette and the glass palette. These are the materials that I use for each one of my paintings. These are the oil colors I use. I use alizarin crimson, which is the color of blood. I use a cadmium red or naphthol red, which is a warm red. I use also a quinacridone red, sap green, ultramarine blue, phthalo or Prussian blue, intense blue, cobalt teal, cadmium yellow medium, cadmium lemon, and titanium white. These are the artistic mediums that I need. These are the ones that you can get in the market in Kenya or wherever you are. Refined linseed oil, which I use equal parts of refined linseed oil and artistic solvent, and put them in a small container. I use it as a medium. For the washing of my brushes, I can use baby oil or artistic solvent. Please never use hardware solvent, and ventilate your studio. Ideally, you will need many sizes and types of brushes. I also use the hardwood brushes that are good for covering big parts of my canvas. the fan brush, very good for blending and for trees, especially acacia trees. Filberts, of different sizes. Bristles, these are the flat square ones. These are the pointer brushes for small details and signing. Some old brushes that are good for blending if they are soft. A metal palette knife. And this is a wipeout tool or anything that can help you get this sharp shape. It takes away the painting. You will see how I use it. It's very nice. A viewfinder, which I make of the shapes of my canvas or panels. And for the cleaning of the brushes, I can use paper towel. This is a thick one, or any rag cloth that I get at home. Thanks for watching. Remember to check the description box below. And if you find this video helpful, please like it and subscribe to my channel. Kwaheri!